parts before this. We have seen what is stress, how it comes through the stressors, how our attitude works on it, and what are the tricks that can be used to move the stress into a positive manner. Okay, so we are today at the fourth part, which will be a concluding practical session type of thing for whatever we have heard through this last three sessions. Of those of whom you have listened to my last three sessions, or you may listen to them, they are available in the DVDs down over there or on the internet also. And today what we will be doing will be a practical session of what exactly we can do to manage our day-to-day stress. Okay? To start off, we'll just start off with a prayer. And I'll explain you certain things and we'll be doing some practicals. Okay? Is it fine with all of you? Okay? Om Sahanavavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karvavahe Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahe. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. In us. Okay? They may be either internal or external. Maybe just a negative thought in my mind, or maybe some event that is happening, some terrorist attack or something that is happening actually externally and I am getting affected of it. Okay, so they can be either internal or external. Then comes, once the stressor is there, second part is my attitude. How I think upon it makes a difference. How I take up that issue, even if it is an external stressor or an internal stressor, how I think over it makes a major difference. We'll be looking in the next slide. And then ultimately comes my stress reaction. Either I get frustrated, I am stressed out and I burst off with a reaction, or else I stay calm and cool. Some people are calm and cool even in the most of the stressful situations. At the same situation, some people start acting weirdly and just more mess of the situation. Okay? So, this everything depends upon my attitude, which we have seen in our second lecture. Now, basically, it goes like this. There are sources of stress which we have seen as stressors. They are either internal or external. Then comes the second step, that is my thought over it, which counts to the attitude. So either it is my positive attitude to look towards that stress, which makes a difference in my stress reaction, wherein I can convert the same stressor either into a eustress or a distress. If the stressor is there, the stressor in itself will not be extremely positive or negative. But my attitude towards the stressor, how I take it up, how I take up that issue. If there is an exam, some people get fever, examination fever. They will give out some rashes, some reactions, and they will land up into some dispensary or hospital instead of landing up into the examination hall. Others will take it very positively. They will think over it. Even if the study is not over, they will say that, okay, I'll do whatever is manageable and I'll try to get through. Okay. So the attitude makes a difference. And this is that positive and negative attitude which we are talking. So either they pass out through the exam or land up into a further more complicated situation that we usually call as stress. When we call that I am stressed out, that time it is distress. Eustress is the good stress which brings about a progress. For anything to happen, there has to be a certain amount of stress. For example, just 10 minutes before starting this lecture, the hall is blank over here. I have come prepared with my lecture. So it becomes a stressful situation for me. Then we decide upon that, let's start. And now when the people come up, yes, it has come up with a to be converted into a eustress. That of course, yeah. Now at least 10 people are in front of me. Had I just broken down or just cancelled the lecture or done off with it, it would have been a distressed situation for me. I would have gone back frustrated. Neither of you, whoever the minimum 10 people are here, would have got the matter which I have collected through my 1 month's research. And ultimately it is a totally distressed situation for me. Next time coming over here, I'll keep on thinking that, oh, they have not created good response for me, and what, how shall I do it? So it becomes a distress. But if I stay cool and positive, no, somehow, somewhere I am reaching out to people. May it be one, may it be 10, may it be 100, that's not a matter. So if I be a positive, I convert it into a eustress, which becomes a progressive step and brings success to me. Okay, so the stress is the same, stressor is the same, but it is my attitude which makes a lot of see difference in the reaction. So ultimately what we have seen is, now we have to bring about this positive attitude into ourselves and give a regular reminder, which you have seen in our part 3. You can just go back to the DVD and see how we have talked upon what are the tricks that we have to use to make our attitude and our reaction to be more positive, to bring that stress into eustress and stay cool in whatever situation happens. Okay, so the thing what we had seen was Kriya Yoga, which plays a very essential part when it comes to, of course, yoga in many ways. As I talked in my last part, that there are many ways in which the yogic philosophy as well as the practical yoga asanas and pranayams, everything, help a lot into stress management as well as building up a healthy human being. But Kriya Yoga has its own chunk. Kriya Yoga always has played a lead role when it comes to a person staying cool and getting into a deeper aspect of yoga. That's why even Patanjali, before talking of Ashtanga Yoga, he has started with Kriya Yoga. Because Kriya Yoga is comparatively a easy process for a lay person to start off in the field of yoga. Because to get into the 8 limbs of yoga, like Yam, Niyam, Asana, Pranayam, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, it requires a lot of attitude. And get into that whole path. So before that, what he has said, okay, then you can do what? You start off with Kriya Yoga. Kriya Yoga is a simple practice. Of course, it has a lot of thing behind it, but it is a comparatively a simple practice which we can do on a regular basis and take us more into the path of yoga. And here, of course, as we are seeing, it helps a lot in our day-to-day stress management. Kriya Yoga basically consists of 3 components: tapas, swadhyaya and Ishwar Pranidhana. I have spoken a lot only on Kriya Yoga. There is a DVD over here. We have taken 1 complete lecture only on Kriya Yoga, wherein I have talked into the details of this and how they are applicable into our day-to-day life.
They have said that pranayama is the best approach. Tapa in general terms, if you put it, it is all the austerity that I do, all the dukkha that I do, whenever I do for whatever thing, whatever social causes I am doing for, everything comes under tapa. Or tapasya is the ritual which you do. Tapa is tapana. So if you take it in this, I can explain it to you. It is getting heated up. So as if the gold when it gets heated up, it shines more brighter and finer and gets more pure and pure. All the impurities are gone. So what they are saying is, for tapas, we can do pranayama. Then for swadhyaya is swadhyaya. But I am looking more myself. It is a self-study. For that self-study, there are many things. break for it. There are Atma-Chintan prayers. Self-help prayers are there. Or maybe or daily routine, diary writing can also come under this one. Wherein I make